How are you doing today?
I'm good, and you?
Good. So basically, we're just going to start off with a few questions just to get some information about your injury, just so that I can better help you. Is that okay? Okay, so first I just wanted to confirm your age. You're 25 years old? Okay, perfect. And Mr. Johnson, could you just tell me a little bit, what do you do for a living?
I'm a postal worker.
How many days a week do you typically work?
About 6 days a week.
6 days a week, that's a lot.
Yeah.
Are you on your feet a lot, or what does that typically entail?
It's usually actually driving.
Okay.
Yeah, I have to drive a lot. And I do walk, but it's both walking and driving.
Okay, well, at least you get a little bit of a balance.
Yeah.
How many hours a day would you say you do that?
Just several hours.
Is there anything else that you do for work besides postal office?
No, that's
No?
it for work.
Okay. And what do you do in your free time for hobbies?
I actually started CrossFit.
Oh, wow. How long have you been doing that?
For like 5 weeks now.
How are you liking
Good, I like it a lot.
it? How many times a week would you say you do it?
About 3 days a week.
That's really good.
Yeah, but I've been having trouble doing CrossFit lately.
Okay. Have you had to cut back or are you still doing CrossFit?
I've had to cut back.
Cut
Yeah.
back. So you're not doing it at all right now?
No.
Sorry to hear that. Well, do my best to get you back to doing CrossFit. I
Cool.
love working out too, so I know the feeling of
Yeah.
not being able to work out.
Yeah.
Okay, is there anything else you like to do for fun? Any other exercise or activities, hobbies?
No,
No?
that's it.
Okay.
Just the gym.
Sounds good. And then let's talk about the reason why you came into the clinic today. So what exactly is hurting you or bothering you?
So it is actually on my right side of my neck, and it goes down a little bit to my shoulder blade. And then I've also had a little bit of numbness and tingling on my hand.
Do you mind if I touch to know exactly where it is? So you said your right shoulder blade, so like around here?
Yes.
Okay. Is there anywhere else that's hurting you?
Just my hand, but it's not hurting.
Your right hand only?
My right hand.
So no pain in your left shoulder or in your left arm?
Nope.
And no pain in your mid back or low back? Okay. And no pain in your lower body? So I marked on my body chart here. Is this where it's hurting you?
Yes.
Okay, good. So if you could just describe the pain that you have in your scapular, your back region.
Well, it's always there. And it bothers me. I don't know how to describe it, but it's just constantly there.
What would you say its pain is right now if you had to rate it on a scale of 0 to 10, 0 being no pain at all and 10 being like the worst pain you've ever had?
Probably a three.
Okay, and then what would you say it at its best rating?
Like a one.
Okay, and then at its worst, like
About a
worst pain?
six.
All right, and would you say it feels more towards the skin or it feels deeper?
I'm not sure. Yeah, I
Okay.
don't know how to describe it.
Okay. And then you said you had numbness and tingling. Okay. What
In my
about,
hand.
oh, in your hand. Okay. So for your hand, how would you describe that pain?
That one comes and goes, but they do come when only when my neck and shoulder blades start hurting.
Okay. And you said there is where you have numbness and tingling.
Yeah, they
Okay.
sometimes do come on by themselves with my hand, but usually it's worse if my neck
Okay.
and shoulder start hurting.
Gotcha. All right. And then what usually like bothers your upper back? Any activities that bother it?
When I look down, it hurts. Also, when I look like back a little bit, and then well, to the right side only.
What about for your hand? Any activities specifically?
No. No, not really.
Okay. Anything else that you can think of that makes your back and hand pain worse?
Well, when I'm working out, lifting weights and stuff, that kind of hurts. It hurts my neck and then it starts hurting my hand.
Okay. And then what do you usually do to make your back and your hand pain go away or feel better?
Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot to mention. Also, when I sneeze, I get a like pain right away.
Okay. Thank you. Okay, so what do you do to make your pain feel better or go away?
Well, I kind of just sit straight up because it hurts to look down, so I sit straight. And then I like to massage my own muscle here, and it feels better when I do it.
Okay. And for what makes it the pain worse, how long would you say that you typically, that it typically takes when you're looking to the right, or if you're lifting, or sneezing for the pain to come on?
A couple of minutes for everything but sneezing. Sneezing is the one that hurts the most right away.
Okay.
And then the other ones just kind of like over time.
Okay. Sounds good. And then for your easing, for what makes it feel better, how long would you say it takes for it to start to feel better?
Also a couple of minutes.
Okay. Yeah.
Sure.
Okay. Anything else that you do to make your pain feel better?
No, that's it.
Okay. And then how would you describe your pain in the morning in your back?
In the morning, it's worse. I would say that it feels the worst when I wake up.
Okay. And then throughout the day, how does it typically feel?
A little bit better.
Better?
Yeah.
That's good.
Mm-hmm.
What about at night?
I have trouble getting to sleep.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do you have trouble, like, when once you fall asleep, does the pain wake you up, or just trouble, like,
No, not actually when I'm asleep, but going to sleep.
Okay, sounds good. All right. And I see from the form that you filled out that you are healthy, you don't have any osteoporosis, you don't have a history
nope.
of diabetes, any history of cancer.
No, okay. No, I'm pretty good.
Is there anything else that you can think of that I should know in that regard for past medical history?
No, I don't think so.
And then, do you have, like, any pain when you're coughing? I know you said you have pain when you're sneezing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, also when I cough.
Mm-hmm. What about when you go to the bathroom, like, number
yeah,
two?
I also have pain
okay.
with that.
All right.
It's kind of weird.
No, that's totally fine. Like, I understand. I need to know that information, so
yeah.
Thanks for sharing.
No problem.
And then how would you say you learn best? Would you want to have like a pamphlet or would you want me to demonstrate?
Maybe both. Yeah, I like seeing it, but I also like doing it myself.
Okay, cool. And do you have like any eyesight issues? Like do you have to wear glasses or do
nope.
you have any trouble hearing?
Nope.
Just so I make sure when I teach you the home exercises, you know how to
how
do
it.
Yeah,
yeah.
In your
no, I'm
okay.
Fine.
And then I saw from your chart that you had x-rays,
mm-hmm.
But they were normal. So
yes.
That's a good thing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. Did you have anything other kind of imaging done from your doctor that he or she prescribed?
No.
Okay. And then as far as medications, what are you taking or are you taking any medications right now?
Yeah, I'm actually taking two. I'm taking ibuprofen and Robaxin, I think.
Okay. How much do you take? Do you know the dosing?
I take 800 milligrams of the ibuprofen.
Okay.
And of the other one, I take 25 milligrams.
And how many times a day would you say you take each?
About 3 times a day for ibuprofen and about 2 times for Robaxin.
That's impressive. You know the dosing. Most people don't. So
yeah,
that
I have to.
Me a lot.
I've been taking them since I started. So.
Okay, so let's go ahead and talk about the day you started having pain, or when this pain first started to come on.
Okay.
So when did you first start feeling the back and the hand pain?
So, I woke up, I had a CrossFit competition, and I woke up the day after, and this was about 2 weeks ago, and I immediately felt pain on my neck, and then I felt it kind of go down to my shoulder blade. And then I did go to the physician that same day, and that's when I started taking the medicine, and I got an injection.
So your doctor prescribed you to take those?
Yes.
Sounds good. What kind of injection was it?
It was a Toradol.
Toradol?
Toradol injection.
Okay. Alright, I'm familiar. Okay. What about your hand? So I know that was specifically your back. When did your hand pain start to hurt?
Well, my hand started a couple of days ago. So like on the third day, so it didn't happen right away. But it's getting like not worse, but it's just stayed the same.
Okay. And did you ever have any like history of neck pain before this or upper back pain at
No,
all?
No, nothing. It was from the competition, I think.
Okay. Did you at least get to compete in the competition?
Yeah,
How
I finished
did you
it.
Do?
I got third place, but
oh,
I'm barely
good.
starting, so it's okay.
That's great. That's awesome. Okay. What are your goals that you want to get out of physical therapy?
Well, I do want to return to competing, so returning to CrossFit.
Yeah, first place.
Yes, hopefully. And then just to be able to move my neck and not have pain.
Okay, sounds good. I'll do my best to help you get back to the gym
Thank
and back
you.
To pain-free movement.
Great.
And then when you came into the clinic, they gave you like a little questionnaire to fill out. Which one did they give you?
It was called the NDI.
Okay. Do you know what you scored on it?
A 19.
I
don't know what that means.
Perfect. That's okay. All right. So now we're going to start the objective portion of our exam. So basically, we're going to do like different tests, different range of motion, strength tests, just so I can determine the reason why you're having that back pain and why you're having your hand pain.
Okay.
So to do this, it'll require me to place my hands on your back, your head, your neck. Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay. Also, how would you rate your back and your hand pain right now on that scale of 0 to 10 before we get started?
The neck and shoulder about 4 out of 10. And the hand isn't there right now.
Okay, sounds good. All right, so if you could take your shirt off, please. Can just remain seated.
Okay,
let's start out.
Yeah.
So first, I'm just gonna have you raise both arms like this overhead, just as high as you can.
Good.
And back down. How did that feel?
Good.
Okay. Mm-hmm. So I'm gonna start with your left arm first, since that's the one that's not really ready. And I'm going to do the movement for you. You're going to reach the arm up overhead. Good. And back down. Now go ahead and do it again. And now I'm just going to apply a little bit of pressure at the end. And relax. How did that feel?
Good.
Good. Okay. Mm-hmm. I'm going to do the same thing on this one. So
sure.
You're just going to bring the arm straight up. Perfect. I'm going to add a little bit of pressure. Mm-hmm. How did that feel?
Good.
Good. Okay. And then the next one we're going to do is you're going to bring both arms up to the side like this.
Mm-hmm.
And back down. How did that feel in both of them?
Good.
Good. Okay. So I'm going to have you do the same with the left arm. You're just going to bring it straight out to the side.
Mm-hmm.
Good. And I'm just going to add a little bit of pressure.
Good.
And how did that feel?
Good.
Okay. Same thing on this side. And how did that feel?
Good.
Okay. So now you're going to bring your left hand behind your back like this.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just going to add a little bit of pressure once again, just to get a little bit more movement.
Mm-hmm.
How did that feel?
Good.
Okay. And then same on this side. And how did that feel?
Good.
Okay. All right, so the next thing we're going to have you do is you're going to cross your arms like this.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to keep your nose in line with your wrist, and all you're going to do is you're going to twist to the right.
Good.
How did that feel?
Good.
And then you're going to do it one more time. I'm going to add a little bit of pressure at the end. How did that feel? Okay, so same thing. You're going to twist to this side and back to center. One more time. I'm going to add a little bit of pressure. How did that feel?
Felt good.
So the next one you're going to do is you're going to keep your hands like this, and you're just going to look down, and you're going to slowly come forward to your thighs, and back out. How did that feel?
Good.
So you're going to do it one more time, and I'm going to add a little bit of pressure once you come down. Good. How did that feel?
Good.
Okay. And then one more time. Go ahead and come back down. And then another one we're going to do, I know there's a lot of different movements. So this next one, you're just going to bring your hands like this. And you're going to let your head fall into your hands, and you're just going to slowly arch your back.
Okay.
Perfect. And go ahead and relax. How did that feel?
Good.
Okay, so you're going to do it again. I'm going to add a little bit of pressure at the end.
Okay.
So go ahead and lean back. Perfect. And how did that feel?
Good.
All right, so the next one we're going to have you do is standing.
Okay.
You could come standing. All right, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to block your hips, so try not to sway your hips back. Try to keep your hips directly over your ankles, and all you're going to do is slide your hands down your legs like you're trying to touch your toes. Good, and back up when you're ready. How did that feel? Okay, so you're going to do it again. I'm going to add a little bit of pressure at the end. How did that feel?
Good.
Okay, the next one you're going to do is you're going to bring your hands like this.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to keep your head looking forward, so don't let your head fall back.
Okay.
And then you're going to keep your hips over your ankles, and you're just going to arch your back and lean back safely. Good. And how did that feel?
Good.
Okay, so I'm going to add a little bit of pressure once again. Go ahead and lean back. And back up. How did that feel?
Good.
Good. Okay, so standing as you are, hands alongside your body, you're just going to slide your right fingertips down your right leg. Good, and back up. How did that feel?
Good.
Same thing on the left, you'll slide your left fingertips down the leg and back up. How did that feel?
Good.
Okay, so this time you're going to slide your hands to the right. I'm going to add a little bit of pressure at the end. And back up. How did that feel?
Good.
Same thing on this side, sliding your fingertips, and back up. How did that feel? Good. Okay. So let me just make a quick note. All right. So the next thing I'm going to have you do is you can just remain seated for now.
Okay.
Basically, I'm just going to, if you could take your socks off too. Just sit as you normally do, like if you're sitting at your workplace.
Okay.
Just however you sit, whatever that might look like.
Okay.
Almost done. If you can move your hair to the side.
Long hair.
Yes. Okay. So now you're going to come to standing, and you're just going to stand like you normally do at the gym, at work, talking to a friend, whatever is comfortable. Almost done here. Okay, perfect. All right, so the next thing we're going to do is I'm just going to have you, I'm going to be testing your balance.
Okay.
So with your shoes off, all you're going to do is you're going to bring your right foot in front of the left like this. And you're just going to try to hold there for about 30 seconds. And you're You're looking pretty steady. Can you maybe close your eyes? Good. And I think that's about 30 seconds. Go ahead and switch feet. Opposite foot in front. Nice. And can you maybe close your eyes?
Oh, I was closing.
And open. Good. Okay, so now what you're going to do is you're going to start over here. And you're just going to walk one foot in front of the other.
Okay.
And then you'll switch sides, bringing the opposite foot in front of the other. Good. All right. All right, so now what you're going to do is I'm just going to have you walk like you normally do at work.
Okay.
So if you can just walk from here to there. Good, and back. And one more time. And back. Good. Okay. Thank you. The next thing we're going to do is if you could just show me a movement that reproduces your pain.
Well, as I said, looking to the right.
Okay, so just like this?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Mm-hmm. All right. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do, you can put your shirt back on for now.
Okay.
Thank you. I'm just going to take a few measurements to see how well your neck is moving.
Okay.
All right. So basically, I'm just going to put this on top of your head.
Mm-hmm.
And now you're just going to look down towards the floor. Good. And back up. And how did that feel?
That was, it kind of hurt my shoulder and neck.
It hurt your shoulder? Your mm-hmm. right shoulder or both
yeah,
shoulders?
My right.
Okay. All right. So I'm just going to do this, all the work. You're
mm-hmm.
just going to relax, but I'm going to bring your head into the position.
Okay.
So just go ahead and come back to neutral. How did that feel?
That one didn't hurt.
That one didn't hurt?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So
I'm going to do just a few more here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so with your head in neutral, so just looking straight out in front of you. All you're going to do is bring your chin up towards the ceiling. Perfect. And back out. How did that feel?
That was good.
Now I'm going to do all the movement for you.
Okay.
So I'm going to do the same type of thing. How did that feel?
It was fine.
It was okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Now the next one I'm going to do is, I'm going to be standing behind you for this one.
Okay.
So I'm going to put this device on top of your head,
mm-hmm.
and it's just to measure how your neck and your head are moving.
Okay.
Okay, so head straight. From here, you're just going to look towards the right.
Okay.
Good. All right, and back to center. How did that feel?
That hurt my neck.
That hurt your
mm-hmm.
right shoulder. Your right
mm-hmm.
shoulder. Okay. And now we're going to do the same thing to the left.
Mm-hmm.
So hold on. Okay, go ahead and look to the left. All right. And how did that feel?
That one was a little bit painful, but it's better once I get out.
Okay. So now I'm going to do the movement for you.
Okay.
And again, you'll just let me know how you feel afterwards.
Mm-hmm.
So with your hand here.
Yeah, that hurts a little bit.
Okay, go ahead and come back out. It was painful, you said?
Yeah, and it kind of caused like the numbing of my hand.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Let's go ahead and do it to the left. Again, I'm going to do all the work.
It was good.
Okay. We have just a few more here. I'm gonna move your hair out of the way, if that's okay.
Yes, I can put it up if you want. Do you want it up?
No.
Okay.
All right, so the next thing I'm gonna have you do is I'm gonna again be behind you, but all you're gonna do is bring your right ear to your right shoulder.
Okay.
And just go ahead and bring your right ear to your right shoulder. Good. And back. How did that feel?
It hurt my neck.
It hurt?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to do all the work and I'm going to do it to that same side.
Okay.
And again, let me know how you feel.
Oh, that hurts already.
Right there.
Okay. Yeah.
All right. And let's go ahead and bring your left ear towards your left shoulder. And back to center. How did that feel?
That feels fine.
Fine? Mm-hmm. And again, I'm going to do all the work, but we're going to do that same movement. And back to center. How did that feel?
That feels fine.
Fine. Okay. All right, so the next thing that we're going to do is what's called a neuroscreen.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm basically just going to be checking how the nerves in your upper back are communicating with the in your upper body, and also testing the strength of your muscles of your upper body.
Okay.
So if you could roll up your sleeves. Good. We're going to start off with the skin sensation. So you'll be closing your eyes, and you'll let me know if one side feels the same as the other side.
Okay.
Go ahead and put your hands faced up. Good. Closing the eyes. Does this feel the same as this?
Yes.
This as go ahead and open up your eyes. And the next thing we're going to do is testing the strength in your upper body. So to do this, I'll just be placing my hands again on your head and your neck.
Mm-hmm.
So the first thing you're going to do is if you can look down towards your chest and don't let me move you. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Hold, hold, hold. How did that feel?
Good.
Okay, you're going to look up to the sky. Perfect. And again, don't let me move you.
Mm-hmm.
Hold, hold, hold. How did that feel?
Good.
Okay, you're going to look towards the right. Don't let me move you. Hold, hold, hold. How did that feel?
Good.
Looking to the left. Don't let me move you. Hold, hold, hold. How did that feel?
Good.
Okay, go ahead and bring your right ear towards your right shoulder. And don't let me move you. Hold, hold, hold. How did that feel?
Good.
And left ear to left shoulder, and let me move you. Hold, hold, hold. How did that feel?
Good.
Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is you're going to shrug your shoulders up, and don't let me press them down.
Mm-hmm.
Hold, hold, hold. How did that feel?
Good.
Arms are going to come like this, don't let me move you. Hold, hold, hold. How did that feel?
Good.
Okay, the next thing we're going to do is you're going to bring your arms like this.
Mm-hmm.
And don't let me move you. Ready? Hold, hold, hold. I'm going to do it again here.
Mm-hmm.
Hold, hold, hold. How did these feel?
Good.
Okay. Hold, hold, hold. How did that feel?
Good.
and hold, hold, hold. How did that feel?
I'm sorry, I forgot to mention that when you were doing the skin sensation, I felt a little bit less on my right hand when you were on the middle finger.
Okay. Yeah. Thanks for letting me know that. Alright, so we're going to do this side. You're going to bring your arm like this. Perfect. Don't want to move you. Mm-hmm. Hold, hold, hold. Good. I'm going to do it from here. Mm-hmm. Hold, hold, hold. Good. From here. Hold, hold, hold. Hold, hold, hold. How did all of those feel?
Good.
You're okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right. We're almost done with this part of the testing.
Okay.
So the next thing you're going to do is bring your hands like this, mm-hmm. and don't let me pull your fingers out.
Okay.
Hold, hold, hold. Hold, hold, hold. How did those feel?
Good.
Okay, thumbs like this. Don't let me press it down.
Mm-hmm.
Hold, hold, hold. Hold, hold. Hold. How did that feel?
Good.
Hands like this. Don't you bring your fingers together.
Okay.
You know it's a weird motion. Good. And now like this. Good. Okay. Finally done with that. The next thing we're going to do is testing your reflexes. Okay. So what we're going to have you do is you're just going to bring your arms like this
mm-hmm.
on your hips. How did that feel?
Good.
How did that one feel?
Good.
Okay. Next thing you're going to do is you're going to bring your hands like this, thumbs up. You're going to flex your arm just a little bit. Good. Okay, relax. And same on this side, flex just a little bit. Good, and relax. And now the next one you're going to do is you're going to bring your hand with your palm faced up. Your bicep tendon here.
Mm-hmm.
And same on this side. Good. And almost done with the reflex testing.
Mm-hmm.
So just go ahead and relax your hand. Same on this one. How did all those feel?
Good.
Okay. Thanks for bearing in and hanging in with me
and
all this stuff. It's a lot of stuff to cover. Okay. So now the next thing we're going to do is you're going to remain seated.
Mm-hmm.
And all we're going to do is I'm going to do all the work for you.
Okay.
But you'll just let me know how you feel after the movement's done.
Okay.
So I'm going to move your hair out of the way if that's okay. All right, I'm going to start with the left side first.
Mm-hmm.
How did that feel?
It was good.
Okay, and now here.
That one hurt a little bit.
That one hurt?
Yes.
All done with that. No more hurting. The next thing I'm going to have you do is you're going to bring your right arm up on top of your head.
Mm-hmm.
Right up here. There you go. How does that feel?
Feels better.
For your shoulder and your hand, both?
Yes.
Or just
for my hand.
Mm-hmm. Alrighty. If you could go ahead and lie down on your back with your head over here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right, go ahead and scoot towards me, if you could. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to place my hand underneath your head. I'm going to do a movement, and you'll let me know how you feel after it.
Okay.
Thanks. away the numbness from my hand, actually.
Okay, how's your back feeling with that?
Good. Good. Okay.
I'm glad it feels better.
All right, and then the next one I'm going to do is you're going to remain lying down. I'm going to do it on your left arm just so you know what I'm doing first. So
okay.
That's the side you don't have any pain on. Mm-hmm. Just so you get comfortable with the movement. All right, so the movement I'm going to have you do about halfway towards the end of this is you're going to side bend your head this way,
mm-hmm.
and then you'll side bend your head this way.
Okay.
Okay? All right, so let me grab your hand here and let me know how this feels. Do you have any pain with this in your hand and your
no.
shoulder? Okay, so now we're just going to kind of drop. Okay, so I'm going to do this movement here. How does this feel?
It's fine.
It's okay. All right, and now what about here?
Good.
Okay. And then if you could side bend right ear to right shoulder, how does that feel?
It's okay. It's the same.
And then left ear to left shoulder?
It's the same.
The same? Okay, I'm going to take you out of this movement. All right, so now we're going to do this on the right side.
Okay.
And again, you'll just let me know how you're feeling. Okay. So same thing. How does this feel?
Good.
How does this feel?
Good.
Okay, what about here?
Good.
What about now?
I feel it.
You feel it?
Yeah, the numbness again.
Okay, go ahead and side bend your head.
Oh, that makes it
worse. And
yeah.
Then what about this way?
Better.
Better?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we'll stop it there. I don't want to make your arm hurt any worse.
Thank you.
All right, so if you could just go ahead and roll over onto your stomach right now. And if you could take your shirt off or just slide it up a little bit, that would be great. Okay. So I'm just going to be basically assessing your back, how it's feeling. I'm going to start with the left side.
Mm-hmm.
Let me know if you have any pain here, any tenderness, any numbness, anything that bothers you.
Okay. Well, right there.
Here? Okay. I'm going to do this side.
That's good.
All right. Alright, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to be pressing down along your spine. I'm not going to go pressing back deep or that intense, just because
okay.
I don't want to hurt your head more or your back.
Okay.
So I'm just going to be pressing about 25% into your back and just let me know how you're feeling. Go down a little bit further just to make sure.
Okay.
Any pain with these?
Right there.
Here?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. A little bit further down. How are you feeling?
Oh, that is good.
Okay.
It feels just a little higher.
All right, I'm going to go off to the side. I'm going to start with the left just because that's the side that's not bothering you.
Okay.
Just so you get familiar. But I'm going to go back to that spot that hurts and come up off
okay.
the side. Okay. and turn your face this way. Good. Are you comfortable here? Okay. As comfortable as it can get. All right. So again, let me know if you have any pain with this. You know where your pain comes on.
Okay.
Here. Okay. All right. Thank you. Almost done with the treatment and evaluation. Okay. So if you can go ahead and have a seat here. If you were to rate your pain on your back and hand on that scale of 0 to 10, how would you rate it now after all that?
It's a little less, so like a 3.
A 3? Mm-hmm. All right, so I'm going to do the first treatment for you today just to see how you're feeling afterwards and if your back feels different. So you're going to lie down on your back to start. With
okay.
Your stomach faced up.
Perfect.
So this is similar to one of the tests I did that helps your head feel better.
Okay.
So just relax and just slide my hand underneath your head here. I'm just holding for about 10 seconds. And how did that feel?
Good, it feels better.
Feels better? Okay. So I'm going to do that 2 more times. And 10 seconds there. How are you feeling?
Good.
How's your hand feel?
Good. It's actually a little bit, a little better.
Okay. Let me do one more.
Okay.
10 second hold here. So if you can roll onto your stomach from here. Okay. I'm going to do it on your right side since you're having your pain. If you could turn your head to the right. Good. Okay. All right. Let me know how you're feeling. Back and your hand feeling?
Good, it's still feeling a little better.
Feels better?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm going to do another 30 seconds of what I just did. And 30 seconds there. How does that feel?
Good.
Okay, so I'm going to do one more bout of 30 seconds. How's your back and your hand feeling?
Good. Yeah, feeling better.
Yay, I'm glad. Okay, go ahead and have a seat. We'll wrap it up from here. Okay. And you can put your shirt on. So, Mr. Johnson, basically, based off our session today, I think you have what's called radiculopathy.
Mm-hmm.
So it's nothing to be afraid of. It'll heal with therapy and with your stretching exercises, mobility. So basically, radiculopathy, what it is you have it in your upper neck area up here, and it's just where you have one of your nerve roots in your neck getting compressed. So that's what's causing the pain and numbness and tingling down into your hand. So what we're going to be focusing on in our treatment and therapy sessions is trying to relieve the pressure off that nerve, just so that you don't have that pain sensation all the time. And I think that you'll do a lot better, and you'll be feeling better and getting back to your CrossFit activity.
Thank you.
If you come for therapy for about 3 weeks, it shouldn't take that long. It has a very good prognosis, so that's a good thing.
Good.
So 3 weeks for therapy, maybe like twice a week. Would that work for you?
Yeah.
Okay. And did you have any questions for me at all?
So should I just rest at home?
So what we're going to have you do for your home exercise program is we're going to get a towel and... So we'll just use your shirt to show you.
Okay.
So with the towel, you're going to place that towel behind your head. I'll just go ahead and show you how to do it.
Okay.
So you're going to be like this. You're going to place it behind your head. You're going to cross the towel in front of your face. And then you're going to look towards the right, and you're just going to gently pull like this.
So like a stretch?
Yes. About 30 seconds of that three times at home. And next time you come in and see me, you'll let me know how you're feeling. Before you leave, I'm just going to check a few things just to see if you made progress with your head since you're feeling better. So if you could just go ahead and look to the right. Good.
Yeah, I can move it more, huh?
And back to center, how did that feel?
Good, a little better than the first time.
Okay, and when you just look to the right, how does that feel now after our treatment?
It still hurts, but I can go a little bit past the point where I felt last time.
Okay, awesome. Well, it was great to meet you, Mr. Johnson, and I'll see you next week.
Great.
Just make sure you practice that home exercise activity, and I'll see you next week.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome. How long was that?
I think it was good time. It's still recording.